We'd like you to subscribe to the Reba, you know. Shout out to all of the good women that's out there. Cause shout out to the Four Tops. Ain't no woman like the one I got. I know that's right. Let's get to the topic today. Some people take their jobs, you know, as their women, their car as their women, because it's so precious to them. And they got so much passion for it, you know, and they take it, you know, as their women. The reason I'm going to get to this is because I was watching the Corey Holcomb show the other night. And Corey talked about your favorite comedian is copying him and biting him. And then they don't want to admit that they're stealing material from him. The Reba Keep It 1000. I think Corey was going back to the Bill Bellamy thing, and he already had, I thought him and Bill had a truce, and they had an interview that went viral, I think. I know they got a lot of views off of it or whatever, and, you know, Corey was backtracking. But it just shows you how Corey is, because after he backtracked and made a truce with Bill Bellamy, you know, I believe he was talking about Bill Bellamy still stealing his material, because he said, you know, when you confront them, they'll lie and deny that they stole your material. And he was going off on Bill Bellamy for stealing his material, the singing part, I think it was, of his show at the beginning, the Reba Keep It 1000. And then he elaborated and said, your favorite comedian wish they could be like him. You know, become outspoken and saying what they want to say. They get inspiration from him because, you know, Corey will say what he says, what's on his mind, and he stand on what he say, and, you know, he's real rambunctious, you know, and outgoing, and, you know, he doesn't care what he say and what people think of him. So, but, and then he talked about how passionate he was for this comic thing, you know, the Reaper Keep It 1000, you know. I believe Corey, you know, is like, you know, that hardworking person that's on a job or whatever, and they may be the hardest worker on the job, but they don't get credit for it. And Corey wants credit up in Hollywood because Corey thinks he's funnier than all of these guys. And I'm not saying that he shouldn't think that, you know, because he talked about, you know, how just because people got more views in the comedy clubs and the comedy clubs is going to get shut down, you know, that they're really shit comedians. That's what he was alluding to. And they don't have no talent, but just because they got a lot of views on social media, these comedy clubs be booking them. And the comedy clubs is in trouble, and they may get shut down. Now, Corey is real bitter because he's been in the game for about 30 years, and he doesn't feel like he's gotten his just due. I know Corey feel like he's a better comedian than Kevin Hart. I know he feels like he's better than Bill Bellamy, Nick Cannon, you know, really all these guys, you know. But, you know, he just don't fit in with what Hollywood wants to do. And that's not because Corey is just so outspoken and so rambunctious like what you guys think. It's just that people, he's not a crossover comedian, you know. I mean, you have to be a crossover comedian, you know, for Hollywood to want to do some things with you. I mean, Corey is very funny to us, but, you know, to Caucasian people or other races, he's not funny to. The Reaper Keep It 1000, you know, they don't get, you know, his humor or whatever. You know, a lot of them find it offensive. So it's not that Corey wouldn't sell out or take, you know, the money or whatever, because we done saw him do that time and time again. So, but he'll make, you know, black folks think that, you know, it's because that, you know, he is a rambunctious comedian. He says what's on his mind and he don't fit into their mode. That may be true to a certain extent, but it's not that, you know, he wouldn't sell out and take the money, you know, the Reaper Keep It 1000, because I believe that Corey is, you know, doing things to try to fool black people like he's on their side, but he's really not. He's just down for the dollar. As you see, the Reaper call him George Jefferson because he will do anything for a dollar like George would. That's underhanded or deceitful if it's for money. The Reaper Keep It 1000. So that's why I call Corey Holcomb, you know, George Jefferson or whatever. You see how he snaked his buddy Zoe, and, you know, he will, you know, backbite you just like he did Bill Bellamy. Now, I don't know if Bill Bellamy took some material, you know, from his show or whatever, but I believe they had a conversation and he should have called Bill, and they did. They got together and had a conversation and everything, and it was supposed to be squashed. So why is Corey bringing it up again? I believe he's like, you know, like I said, the hard worker at the job, but just don't get the credit that they should. or whatever, and they're really bitter behind the scenes, or he's like, you know, like just like some dudes, they talk about, some NBA players talk about some dudes, you know, that's better than them, but they didn't make the league, you know, the Reaper keep it 1,000 because they didn't fit in to, you know, what they wanted to do in the NBA, or something happened, you know, and that's what Corey is. Corey is that hardworking comedian figuring that he can write jokes and he's funnier than them guys. That's why I call him the Red Fox. You know, he's like Red Fox. He, like, Red Fox really didn't get his just due until he was older. And Eddie Murphy brought him back, you know, for some movies and stuff like that. But Red Fox didn't get his just due until he was older. And that's how Corey Holcomb is. Corey Holcomb is not going to get his just due as a funny comedian until, you know, I mean, he's already in his 50s. It may be till he in his 60s. You know, they give him a sitcom as a grandfather or something. He be cracking jokes and he be rambunctious. But he gonna be too old to kind of enjoy it. The Reaper gave it 1,000. You know what I'm saying? But he's hoping Hollywood give him a lick. And don't fool yourself. Corey will do anything or throw anybody up under the bus just to get that lick. You know, so don't let him fool you and think just because, you know, he says and does anything and he don't fit in with Hollywood people, that's why he ain't got the shot, you know. He ain't, you know, and that he won't sell out, because he will for the money. And he already do to a certain degree. The Reaper keep it 1,000. I see Corey for what he really is. He's down for that dollar. You know, and he'll do anything to persuade people, you know, he'll do anything for that dollar, and he's got no choice but to be with us, because he's not accepted by the Hollywood crowd, so he's got no choice but to be with us, so he try to make us believe that, you know, he's down. He wouldn't sell out for money, but he would in a minute. And he wants to be in that Hollywood circle. And this is why he talks about it on his 5150 show. Because it's therapeutic. And Corey talks about things that he's going through in his life, his marriage, his sister. You know, he talks about personal things sometimes on his 5150 show. Just like he talked about when he said, what he said, when a woman say that pussy is bi, he say he start to think that she's trying to manipulate him or con him with some witchcraft type of stuff, because she'll let anybody jump up and down in that pussy. He said, I believe he's talking about, you know, his wife and what's going on in his marriage. You know, the Reaper keep it 1,000 and some of the things that he done been through in life. So Corey will lay that kind of stuff out on the line, because the 5150 show is controversial. That's what it stands for, chaos, and that's where a lot of chaos go on, you know, on his 5150 show. But I believe Corey Holcomb is bitter because he hasn't got his just due, and he see these guys that's not as funny as him getting their just due. Reaper, we keep it rough, we keep it raw, we keep it real. Make sure you subscribe to the Reaper, because I'm doing very good things here at